Kim W, I drank from a puddle and I got the... Kim W, why did you drink from a puddle? Hey guys, you're probably here because you want to know all about those eye floaters. Are they serious? And when should you seek medical attention? Well, I'm going to answer that question, along with many other questions, in this week's Responding to Your Comments, where we look at fun questions, we look at science-based questions, but most importantly, we always look at the evidence. Amy DBZ, can you please do a video about floaters? Amy, thank you for your comment, sending you and everyone who's watching this video awesome vibes wherever you are in the world, and of course I can do a video on this topic. I imagine you're talking about eye floaters and not the other type of floaters, but if I'm wrong, please leave a comment below and let me know. So let's begin. So eye floaters are actually very common, and usually they're nothing to worry about, which is the good news. But there are certain situations where you will need to seek medical attention and medical advice quite urgently. Now I am going to discuss these later in the video. I'm also going to leave loads more information in the description below, so feel free to check it out whilst I'm talking. Now in case you're thinking to yourself, what on earth is an eye floater or a floater? They are both the same thing, and they appear in our field of vision as a black or translucent spots and strands. Sometimes they kind of have the appearance of like a bug or a worm moving about in our field of vision. Eye floaters are actually more noticeable when we're looking at a bright plain background, let's say like a white wall or the sky. We usually tend to notice them more at this point. They kind of drift into our field of vision and float across out of our field of vision. Hence the name floaters, because it seems like it's floating. Now before we continue, let's first understand what's causing them. So these floaters are actually tiny debris which are found in the fluid of the eye, known as the vitreous humor. So the vitreous humor is a jelly-like substance which is found in the space in the middle of the eyeball. Now children have a fairly solid vitreous humor, but as we age, our vitreous humor becomes more watery. This is completely normal, by the way. And these eye floaters then appear when clumps of the vitreous humor move around in this watery substance. So because of this, the clumps that we've just mentioned cast a shadow on the retina. The retina is the light sensitive part of the eye, and this shadow causes those spots and strands that we spoke about earlier, which are known as floaters. So this means that as we get older, we're more likely to get floaters. That was a super simplified explanation of the whole thing, but I think it's good to have a basic understanding of it all. Now these kinds of floaters that we've just discussed are not associated with flashes, a reduction in vision, and usually come on gradually with time. They also tend to settle at the bottom of the eye with time, below the line of sight. And after a while, floaters tend to become less noticeable. Now floaters are also more common in those who are short-sighted, which is very common. Here in the UK, 1 in 3 people are short-sighted. And if you're confused between short-sighted and long-sighted, short-sighted means that objects at distance appear blurry, and objects that are close, so short distance, you can see them clearly. So I think we now have a basic understanding of floaters, why we get them, and who's more prone to getting them. But when should you seek medical attention? Because they're in your field of vision, and I imagine a lot of people watching this video will be worried about them. So let's look into this. So when we're looking at floaters, I want you to think of it like this. If you're someone who gets floaters or flashes of light in your field of vision, it's not usually something to worry about. If one, you've had them for a long time, two, they're not getting any worse, and three, it's not affecting your vision. But if you do get any of the following, you need to seek medical advice promptly, and I think the best way for me to do this is just to list through them. So if you get floaters or flashes of light suddenly, like you've never had them before and you suddenly get them, if your floaters or flashes of light suddenly increase in number, if you have a dark curtain or dark shadow moving across your field of vision, if you have blurred vision with your floaters, if you have eye pain with your floaters, and if you get floaters after an eye surgery or any trauma or injury to the eye, all of these, you need to seek medical attention urgently for them. I will leave loads more information about these all in the description below too, with more details on them, so please read them. So these are all signs of a serious problem with the back of the eye, which could permanently affect your vision if it's not treated quickly. So please remember them, read them again, learn them, so that you can act quickly if it ever happens. Thank you for the question, sending you all awesome vibes, and I hope you found that information useful. Now let's move on to the next comment. Vinayak Lagata. A day without watching Abraham the Pharmacist is a FOMO full day. Vinayak, thank you for your comment. I completely agree with you. You are doing great, sir. Love from India. Vinayak, thank you for your comment. This is from the keto diet video where we discuss everything keto diet related, whether it's bad for you, whether it's good for you, the evidence behind it, does it help you lose weight? So if you haven't seen that video, I will leave a link up here to it. And once again, thank you for your comment, sending awesome vibes to you and everyone who's watching this video, especially in India, a very beautiful country with a lot of beautiful history. I've never actually been to India, but we do have a lot of viewers from India, so sending you all awesome vibes. And Yeah, I'd love to visit India one day. So if you could leave a comment and let me know different places to definitely visit, I'd really appreciate it. Thank you for your comment. Waters, him, 1.2 million people visit their doctor every year. The views, 1.2 million. Waters, thank you for your comment. This is from the how to get rid of a sore throat video. You know, to give you all a bit of context, in the video I said that 1.2 million people visit their doctors every single year in the UK for a sore throat, and they're asking for antibiotics and all this sort of stuff. And in that video I talk about what you can do to help with a sore throat. But it's amazing because when I first made that video, obviously I never thought it would get 1.2 million views, and I think now it's got 1.5 million views. And I'm really proud that I'm able to help so many people around the world with many different minor ailments and giving them tips and tricks and things that they can do for self-care, and also knowing when to speak to a doctor or a healthcare professional for more advice. So thank you for your comment, and thank you to everyone for watching and supporting me.
Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.